Hello and welcome to SLS 2301 Career Development. I just wanted to share a little about me and our class. I'm your instructor, Professor Chrissy Leonard. I've been at the college for 31 years. I'm married, I love cats, and I'm an avid Pittsburgh sports fan, my Penguins for hockey and my Steelers for football. I was born and raised there by Hungarian and German immigrant parents, and that was until I moved to Florida after graduate school. My background is career counseling, and I do love teaching this class and helping you find the best education and career that will give you the quality of life and satisfaction that you seek. I hope that we will cover what will help you find your path, your best fit, and along the way, presenting yourself professionally so that you can get that dream job. I just wanted to give you a few hints of how to make a successful start. Begin by checking your Falcon Mail. You should get it in the habit of doing that daily. We start over from here. I just wanted to give you a few hints of how to make a successful start. Begin by checking your Falcon Mail. You should get in the habit of doing this daily. There are ways that you can put it on your smartphone to make it more convenient as well. So if you're interested in that, just let me know and I can get you that information. To make it even easier, you can, instead of just logging into My Daytona State and going to your Falcon Mail, you can actually use the widget in our class. I'll just scroll down here. When you get down here to this Microsoft 365, you can click right here and look for email there. If it does say that you need to log into your account, just click on it and it will automatically log you in because you're already in Falcon Online. Just get in the habit of every time that you log in, check if you have email. And this is your primary method of staying up to date and being informed. Additionally, check your announcements every time that you log in. This will help you stay up to date with reminders, updates, and other information that I think that you will find helpful. If you don't need that information after you've read it, then you can just simply click on this X and it will dismiss the announcement and remove it from your feed so that you can declutter. So let me show you a few pages that should get you off to a good start and answer most of your questions. Now, you won't have access to Falcon Online course shells until 12:01 a.m. on the first day of class, any given semester. That's how it works. So when you do gain access, make sure to log in as soon as possible and start exploring the course shell. First, read the course announcements, like I mentioned. Then you want to go to content in the navigation bar and start with the welcome pages. So that's that module right there. You want to read those pages and watch all of the videos on those pages so that that can help you to get started. Now, when you come to the syllabus, homework schedule and textbook information, it gives you specific information that you need for the course, such as materials, course calendar, and course policies. The textbook page gives you the information for our required textbook. Get your textbook as soon as possible. Purchase it, get it shipped, or if you're dual enrollment, pick it up from your guidance designee as soon as possible to prevent any delays. You also want to read pages and watch all the videos found in the Grading and Assignment Expectations module to find how-tos and expectations and videos. You'll want to review all of these modules, including reading the syllabus in detail. The modules should answer most of your initial questions. Now, you will note that there are dates by each module. I only allow you to access content, not all assignments, a week ahead. I want you to spend time on the course lecture materials, the pages, the websites, and videos, not just quickly click through them. Now, I did create these resources here in these beginning modules to help you learn how to navigate the course shell and its tools and navigate it effectively. You have access to all of this all semester. So please go back to visit it if you need it as a reference point for anything. Now, if you are confused about anything in our first week or anytime throughout the semester, make sure to contact me as soon as possible. The fastest way to get a response is to email me. Now, if I scroll up to the top here, you'll see class list here in the navigation bar. All you need to do is click on that, then scroll down to find my name, put a check in it. There's a little box in front of it, and then scroll right back to the top of the page and choose email or send email, I think it says. That sends me an email directly from our class and will include our course and section number that makes it much quicker and easier for me to respond to you. I do check email frequently throughout the day. Now, if you do need to meet with me virtually, I will send you a Teams appointment so that we can chat online and share screens if necessary. Now, if you want to reach me live, you can call or you can visit me on campus in my office during my office hours, my scheduled office hours, and that's found on our homepage on the course widget. So let me show you that. Here are my office hours right here. Now, if my scheduled hours don't fit your schedule, just email me and make an appointment. The takeaway here is that I don't want you to be afraid to ask for help, and I want you to be successful. If you take the time to follow these recommendations, you should set yourself up for a good start. The key is communication. Anytime that you feel confused, stuck, or that you need help. So let's have a great semester.